واغفر لمن Yeah. يكبرون الله تعالى على كل شرف ويصفون في الصلاة المسلم يشهد ان الله الراضي الى حرمته
Love you.
Oh, Yeah.
Alhamdulillah, majlis mengucapkan ribuan terima kasih kepada pendiri majlis pada pagi ini. Yang pertama, kita mengucapkan ribuan terima kasih kepada Al-Fadhil Al-Habib Ali Zainal Abidin bin Abu Bakar Al-Habib. Semoga Allah SWT memanjakan rahmat beliau dan seorang rahsia dan terus berjuang mendakwah kepada manusia kepada jalan yang benar, insyaAllah. Dan yang kedua, kita mengucapkan ribuan terima kasih kepada Al-Fadhil Al-Habib yang telah menyampaikan kasidah-kasidah mereka yang sangat merdu. Pimpinan Ustaz Umar Maulana, semoga Allah SWT menjaga umat juga dan seorang rahsia. Amin ya Allah. Dan juga kita mengucapkan jazakumullah khair kepada tetamu undangan kita, Al-Habib Hasan bin Muhammad bin Salim Al-Attas, atas bacaan maulid Ibrahimnya. Semoga Allah SWT memanjangkan umur beliau dalam keadaan sihat dan walafiat. Para jemaah yang dirahmati Allah sekalian, di sini ada satu pengumuman. InsyaAllah selepas solat zuhur nanti kita akan menyediakan jamuan. Tapi di sini ada permintaan agar kita penangguhkan sembahyang sunat ba'diyah selepas ada jamuan. Kerana itu sebab yang pertama, kerana tempat tidak mengizinkan. Pasangan nanti ada yang sedang makan dan ada yang sedang solat. Jadi kita tangguhkan sedikit sembahyang ba'diyah zuhur tu setelah jamuan. Dan yang kedua, pasal takut nanti tak khusyuk bila sembahyang ba'diyah. Ya, itu saja. Baik. And now I would like to invite our Sheikh, our Maulana Fikri Al-Jalani to give his talk. Tafadhal Sheikh.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Sayyidi Al-Habib Hasan Muhammad bin Salim Al-Abbas Fadullahu alaihi Yura Rahmatu Al-Barakat Sayyidi Al-Habib Jalal Al-Shatari Hayatumullah Mubarak Fikum Fi Hadha Al-Majlis Wada'im Allah Habibana Al-Habib Akhina Al-Fadil Habib Ali Zain Al-Abidin Muhammad Jazakumullah Khair Barakallahu Fikum. My beloved brothers and sisters, Ustaz, Habayib, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. First of all, I would like to say thank you so much for Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who allow us through his love to be here together today. But first of all, we say salatu wassalamu alayka ya Sayyidi ya Rasulullah for being the ship that carry all this ummah, for being the guide who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent you to unite the hearts of its people. No matter what are their races, their language, their colors, from where they came, but through your love, we are united today, celebrating our beloved, uniting our hearts. InshaAllah, always dunya and akhirah. And secondly, we would like to say thank you so much, Jazakumullah khair, my beloved brothers and sisters, terima kasih banyak for being generous to attend this majlis today, to share this blessed moment together. I know it is public holiday today, but we should use it not in sleeping only, but using something benefitize and benefit our families. To get together and to pray to Allah for the best of dunya and akhirah. Happiness and peaceful life, inshallah, for all of you, especially in this beloved country, Singapore, inshallah. And thirdly, I would like to thank you so much for our brothers, the organizers, for organizing such a beautiful program, starting from Masjid Abdul Razzaq, MLJ, and all those who they help to organize this majlis together and today, so that all of us will enjoy this blessed moment where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be pleased, inshaAllah. And as my beloved Ustaz Muhammad Iqbal, Jazahullah khair, sorry sir, I didn't mention your name because your name is in my heart already. As he mentioned, when he mentioned about the hadith of Sayyidina Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the incident when he came out and he saw Sahaba gathering, so So you say, why you are here? They say, Ya Rasulullah, to praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to be thankful to Him also for the blessing that He has sent you to us. For us to be, you know, among this ummah. So it's a great blessing, alhamdulillah, for us to be here and to enjoy these blessings. Majlis based on a foundation. The foundation is the love of Allah and Rasulullah. No hatred, no hard feelings about towards anyone. Those whom they are friends, may Allah make them best friends. And those whom they are enemy, may Allah bless them, may Allah bring them to be friends. Nothing. We never insult, no insult anyone, no hatred towards anyone. No. The message of Rasulullah is a message of Sayyid Ustad Iqbal Mishir. He came to Mecca, no Muslim. Nothing. They have a hatred towards him, but he changed all this to full love towards him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So whoever follow the Sunnah of Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Sunnah of Jama'ah, the first and the most important one is the Sunnah of Al-Akhlaq. وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَى خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ صلى الله عليه وسلم. Can any of us smile in the face of his brothers, sisters, his family every day? Can the husband smile in the face of his wife every day? Or she smile in the face of her husband every day? Impossible sometimes, right? We are human beings. But Al-Mustafa ﷺ, he used to smile in the face of his enemies. See how? This is how going to bring the people. The good akhlaq, the moral character. We remember the people whom they left us to the next world, not because of their position or their money or how they look like or where they live. No. We remember because of their attitude. We say, Allah yarham so and so, Arwah so and so, he was a very nice person, was generous, he was helpful, he was a person of good advisor. See, that's how we're going to praise others, and others going to remember them as well. The akhlaq is like sugar. You know, when you want to have tea, you have to put what? Sugar is bitter, and the tea is bitter. You have to put sugar in the tea to make it sweet. So that's how, if there is anything, anyone who is having any problem with him, you shouldn't face him in the same. No? You shouldn't. Yani if he's fire, you have to be what? Water. Correct? That's how the akhlaq is. And there are people, they are always sweet, in fact. No need for them to have sugar or something. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. So, the advice is, we want through these types of gatherings, the message we have to carry out from this masjid is that our akhlaq have to be, ourselves have to be as Rasulullah used to be. The best school in this world, the best ever school being established in this world was the school of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. School of etiquette, school of attitude, school of moral character, school of generosity, school of mercy, school of accepting everyone, school of dialogue in a good manner with everyone. بالحكمة والموعظة الحسنة وجادلهم بالتي هي أحسن. That's how the message of Islam should be. We don't want to see any lecturers or speakers when he give talk, his face, sour face or attacking or shouting. No, yeah, if you talk and smile, the people will accept you. Remember, people will always remember the smile because it's the Sunnah of Sayyidina al-Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The message we have to carry is the message to our children. Our children. Let me relate to you one very beautiful story happened nowadays. I just want us to imagine that our children should be in the same way. We should bring up our children in the same way. I mentioned this in my lectures for the past few days, in fact, almost every lecture. But I really like it. There is a mother, she has her son, he's a student in a school, So when she sends him every day to school, she provides him with a sandwich of food for him, you know, to eat in the break time. But when he comes back home every day, he comes back very hungry. So she was surprised why he's hungry. And she actually provides him food every day. He should be, you know, okay. But when he comes, he jumped to the kitchen immediately. So she wants to know, but the son never said anything. One day when she went to parents' meeting, the teacher, before he talked about his how is he in his study, his marks and other, straight away he mentioned to her, he said, "I have not seen someone like your son." She was happy with the other. "I have not seen someone in a moral character like your son. He's too generous." He's talking about what? This teacher. He said, "Your son every day when he comes to school in a time of having food break hours, he will give up all his food to others. Divide, he gives especially for those who are hungry, for those who maybe cannot offer. He gives everything, even his water." See, every day he do the same. Surprising, correct? Something beautiful to see, to hear that about your son or your daughter. But what surprised me, is when the mother asked the son, she said, "Why you never tell me about that?" He said, "If I tell you, I will lose my reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala." Such a blessing. Huh? What is this? This is a tarbiyah. This is akhlaq. This madal is teaching us when we attend any majlis, ratib, zikr, mawlid, gatherings, lectures, we have to benefit our children as we benefit them from, you know, buying them mobile phone, clothes, and put them in school for education. Because the teacher, he praises the son, not because of the study. There are many good students and many lazy students, but this one something different. This one, he gained the love of everyone. There is another girl, she was walking in the market when she saw an ice cream shop. Immediately, she performed sujood to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the one who saw her said, "Why you do that?" He said, "Because my mother, whenever she's happy, she makes sujood to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala." Oh, that's how the people can see our house, can see inside our house through our children. And that was the message of the mother of Sayyidina Shaykh Abdul Qadir Jailani when he was leaving to continue his study. And she said to him, "I'm not going to meet you after this anymore, but hope inshallah in Jannah. And I have one advice for you, one gift." "What is a gift?" He said, "My son, please promise me now, and Allah is your witness, that you won't lie. You will say the truth always." He said, "Mother, wallahi, I will promise you that Allah is my witness, that I won't lie in my life. I will say the truth." And he left. Examine, and you know the story, you have read the story. When he, on the way, he met the thieves. They got the caravan, they attacked the caravan where Sayyidina Shaykh Abdul Qadir traveling together with them, and they took everything. When they come to him, they found him very simple, nothing. So one of them said, "You have anything?" He said, "Yes, I have golden dinars." They thought he's joking with them, you know. So he didn't pay attention to that, but they were like, "What is this?" So he said to the chief, the thief said to the chief, "You know, one of them, he's like joking, he's mocking us, bullying us there, eh?" "So where is he?" Came to him. "Say, how do you claim that you have gold?" "Who will say to the thief, I have gold?" He said, "Yes, I do have. Where is it?" He opened his jubba in this part under the armpit, you know, the mother stitch for him, special pocket, and hide it, few dinars for his trip. She didn't say to him, declare this to me, she does not have to say it. But he took it seriously in everything, in all parts of his life. He said, hey. The thief shot. He said, why you tell us? You just keep quiet. He said, I have promised my mother that I won't die. He said, no, your mother is not here. He said, Allah is my witness. Allah witnesses that. So how about I'm going to say to Allah and to my mother one day? The thieves, when he hit that, the memory, his life story, the thief's story, life story, gone to the, you know, those the people he have stealing them, doing this. He said, it's one day, and you cannot keep quiet, and you, because Allah looked to you and that promise of your mother, you made to your mother. And how about us? He said, when he said, Allah, today I declare my tawbah nasuh to Allah. And all of them. Why? As-siddiq. Truthfulness. As-sadiq al-ameen. Sayyid Iqbal also did mention. As-sadiq al-ameen. Sayyidina Rasulullah has built his name for 40 years. His name in Mecca. No need to say Muhammad. They say as-sadiq al-ameen. They know him. They will know. They will lead you to him. He built akhlaq. As-siddiq wal-amana. Sadiq, truthful. Amana, trustworthy. This is something very important in our life. Any of us, when his son or daughter becomes sick, straight away we run to doctor. Fever, doctor. Very concerned about them. Fine. Put them in a school. Wake up them at exactly on the time to go to school because they shouldn't reach late. We ourselves get up early and go to our office early. Because if we go late, they will be problem. But any of us care when their children dies to say life, say okay, don't do it again. That is also sickness. Lying is a sickness. We have to teach them to say the truth. The sunnah of Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Why? Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Ya ayyuha al-lazina amanu taqullah wa kuhu ma'al as-sadiqeen. The whole believer have taqwa and be with a truthful one. That's why Sayyidina Shaykh Abu Tajani called the people around here. Because of the truth. We need our children to be the same. The message of this gathering, the lectures, have to be always there. We have to get the benefit. The new generation waiting for us. Now, the akhlaq is... I would call it to do the same work of mobile phone, but in another way. Mobile phone, our phones now, make the one who is far close. But make the one who is close far. When you sit among families, very seldom you see we are talking with each other. Everyone carry the phone and tick. Right? Halas. The one who took someone, I don't know where is he, somewhere in this world, communicating. But with the parents and brother, sister in the house, no communication anymore. Akhlaq, different. Make the enemy close friend. Make the one who's far, close. And make the one who's close, closer. See how? The moral character. It's hard to be like that. Have to be in this way. There is one African guy, he was attending a meeting in Europe somewhere. So when he was to attend, he came wearing his traditional uniform in Africa, you know they have. So he was to enter, they say, stop, let this person across. Someone went with a stick. So he said, why he entered before me? They say, he's a nobleman. He said, I thought noble through the character, not to the suit, the cloth. Huh? I thought the noble. You be noble through your good character, not through the way you dress. وَتَزَوَّدُوا فَإِنَّ خَيْرَ الزَّادِ التَّقْوَى. The best food at taqwa, and the best cloth, وَلِبَاسُ التَّقْوَى ذَلِكَ خَيْرٌ. The cloth of taqwa. We can hide ourselves while wearing nice clothes and, you know, beautiful things. But how to hide what is in our hearts from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That the place where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is looking to our akhlaq. We have to change this situation. We hope that inshallah these types of majalis and gatherings to be continued everywhere, so that the people benefit from the talk, people benefit from what they hear, and also to increase the level of mahabba, the love in the hearts of ourselves. We are in need nowadays for love between us. Because there are a language of hatred also there. But when the love which is new comes, automatically the dark will disappear. Automatically the darkness will go. Listen the message of Sayyidina Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. How he advised and compared it to what is happening nowadays from the qualities of people who might have problem with themselves first before they have problem with others. When they spread the language of hatred, na'udhubillah, may Allah protect us all, inshallah. There is a riwayat in Sunan Ibn Majah that Sayyidina Al-Bara bin Azib, Al-Bara bin Azib narrated. He say, I came one night to guard Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to be his guard, to be there for him. And there was a man reciting loudly the Quran. He recited the Quran. So Rasulullah came sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he came wondering, what is this? So I said to him, oh ya Rasulullah, this man is showing off. He's had the Quran to show off. Because he was upset. Why he's doing this? He recited just like, you know, silently. For you to recite. Then this person passed away. He said, this man died in Al-Madinah. He said, when they finished preparing him, they carried him, the janazah. Then Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to them, be gentle with him, for he loved Allah and his messengers. When the person who was reading loudly, Sayyidina Bara thought he is showing off. And then, when they went to the grave and to bury him, Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, make it spacious for him. May Allah make it spacious for him. So Ashab, some of them, they say, Rasulullah, you grieve for him, this person? He said, yes, indeed, for he loved Allah and his messengers. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We cannot judge the people just because they the way they talk. And we cannot judge and label people, you are out of Islam, or you are in Islam, and you are in Jannah, and you are in Jahannam. Who are we? Are we ourselves ready to, if we leave this world, are we ready to be, or we think that we are going to go to Jannah in the first place? Is our 5-time prayers with no khushu', within 24 hours, half an hour we pray, that going to carry us to Jannah? Yani? What is it going to do? This heart need, first of all, we have to have pure heart, so our salat will change. Jalaluddin Rumi radiallahu anhu, philosopher of love, said, every and each person have chosen his way of worship, and I have chosen love, mahabba. I love everyone. You know why? He has chosen the right path, straight, direct. Why? When you have a pure heart, you will have a good connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But if this heart full of so much things, I don't know how we are going to have the khushu'. Can you imagine nowadays, when you say Allahu Akbar, the dunya will come immediately. And this is supposed to be the place, the only 1 or 2 or 5 minutes to spend it with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala until we don't know how many rak'ah we pray. 2, I don't know, and then after that sujood sahu. Or usalli al-fajr qara'an. This is what's happening, may Allah protect us. So, ya akhi, dear brothers, sisters, it's wallahi, tell you, great opportunity that all of us here today. I know some of our brothers outside sitting, you know, maybe it's not cool enough for them, but I hope that the majlis is cool for your hearts, inshallah. And our sister also, and others in the other houses, they open, Jazakumullah khair, Habib Abdul Qadir, Al Haddad, and you know, open the house for others to sit in the house and listen. Jazakumullah, this is something great, Allah. Alhamdulillah. That is itself showing the love. That itself is something great. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. So, this has to continue with us all the time. These qualities we need it nowadays. We need more understanding in the house between husband and wife and between parents and children. Because we want our house to be a house of tranquility, maskan. We just don't want to have huge houses but empty from the main reason of being in the house, which is tranquility. We need to have a rizq, alhamdulillah, food. But with that rizq, we have to be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All these qualities going to bless us to be among those whom Allah loves subhanahu wa ta'ala. So there is no worry about anything in our life as long as we know how to be rich. Who is the one who is rich? Is the one who has lots of money? This one we call him wealthy. Rich, the one who is satisfied with everything he has. Alhamdulillah. A poor person came to a wise man and he said to him, "Ya Sheikh, ask Allah to give me wealth so that I can, you know, spend. Why I am poor like that?" The wise man said to him, "Because you are poor because you never used to give." He said, "To give? What to give? I am very poor. What to give?" He said, "Smile in the face of others, sadaqa. Give them sadaqa, smile. Talking nicely to the people, sadaqa. That's also you can give. Being a helpful person to the people, that's another sadaqa." So lots of sadaqa, but we think always the sadaqa when we have money. Careful. When you have got money, you might get, na'udhullah, tama also. You see what we do or normally when we give sadaqah, we choose the old ones to give and keep the new one. We give a new one only in Eid for the kids. Sahih? The balance of our food, we give to the poor after what we eat. Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he sit with anyone, and when he will eat with his servant, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They will eat before him, in fact. That is the way of Sayyidina Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That's how it should be. Let me end with one advice in one story by a wise man to his son. I have not, didn't make the talk long. Because we can still Khazura and continue after Asr, no problem until Asr. If you really enjoy, you say you are enjoying. Now, a wise man said to his son, maybe mentioned, but it's very important. He said to him, "My son, make sure that you will eat the best food in your life. Don't miss eating the best food. And sleep in the best beds, the most comfortable one. And live in the best houses, the most luxurious houses." So the son was surprised. He said, "Father, we are very poor. How to eat the best food, sleep in the best bed, and live in the best houses?" This is a message to us, to our children. He said to him, "My son, when you are hungry, that food is considered the most delicious food. See, when we are fasting in Ramadan, when you look to the water, our children sometimes we cut them because they see biscuit, they want it too tasty, too delicious for them." And he said to him, "When you come back home after long working and very tiring day, the bed you're going to sleep is considered the most comfortable bed. The most comfortable bed. And when you deal with people with goodness, you will live in their hearts. And that is the best house you can live ever. The house is this heart. How many people we live in their hearts now, and how many people living in our hearts. Prepare your house. Prepare your house for others to live in that house. And so they will prepare their house for you to live in their house, which is the hearts. And that's how it should be. إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهَ to go to Jannah, to reach to Jannah, to enter Jannah, بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. The condition is pure heart. May Allah bless us with pure heart. May Allah grant us to be among His beloved servants. May Allah bless us to benefit from these types of majalis. May Allah grant us, subhanahu wa ta'ala, to be sincere, to be truthful, to be generous, to be a people of good akhlaq, to be the best teachers for their children, to give them more adab, more akhlaq, more understanding to the reality of this life, so that if we leave them, they know how to live peacefully in this life, because they have the foundation of the life with them. They know how to live. May Allah grant them, inshaAllah, to be among those, the chosen one, to carry the flag of Ar-Rahman, mercy and love everywhere in this world. May Allah grant us with mahabbah between us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to clear and remove all the differences between our hearts. So make it one heart, because one heart to be connected to the heart of Sayyidina Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala remove the spiritual sicknesses from our hearts, as we ask Him to remove the physical sicknesses from our bodies. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to be among His best ibad. Those who, when they face Qibla, when they say Allahu Akbar, they feel they are in His presence, subhanahu wa ta'ala, and He is listening to them. May Allah bless us to be, whenever we do zikr and read Quran, to know that we are talking with Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala, and He is listening to us. May Allah grant us, subhanahu wa ta'ala, tawbah nasuh, happiness in our houses, in our society, with everyone around us. May Allah protect us from all bala and musibah. May Allah protect us from any things that are going to disturb our lives. And for those who may have any misunderstanding towards others, Ya Allah, be their guide. They are our brothers and sisters. Bring them back with hidayah. Ya Allah, for those whom they are beloved to us, and we are beloved to them, increase this love between us. Make us, Ya Allah, as Sahabatul Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Make us to be like Al-Muhajireen wal-Ansar. Make us to be as those whom they really followed the instruction of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because they are the one who graduated from the best school of the world. Ahlul Bayt was Sahaba. Graduated from the school of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the best school, because it has the best principle, which is Sayyidina Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah grant us all, inshaAllah, siha wal afiyah, rizq al halal, barakah, fi dunya wal akhirah. Ya Allah, bless us with peaceful life, happiness, Ya Allah, everywhere. We need to see everyone happy, because end of the day, if they are not brothers in Islam, they are all equal to us in humanity. So we have to live peacefully together with everyone. As Sayyidina Ali radiallahu anhu mentioned, and Sayyidina Umar. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all to be the hands which open all the doors of good deeds for others to enter. And may Allah bless this hand to be the door which closes all the doors of evil deeds, so prevent others to enter. May Allah grant us, inshaAllah, to be among the salihin wa salihat. May Allah bless you all, inshaAllah, hajj mabrur when you go. Umrah mabrur and ziyarat al-Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And may Allah grant us and grant the people of Masjid Abdul Razzaq barakah fi dunya wal akhirah. May Allah grant al-Habib Hassan siha wal afiyah. Habib al-Jailani, al-Habib Ali Zain Abidin al-Hamid, Ustaz Salih, Ustaz Muhammad Iqbal. Akhura Ustaz Hasbi, Jazakallah khair for coming. Jazakumullah khair, Ustaz. Barakallah fikum. And may Allah bless you all for all your dua to be accepted. To the one who have the power of kun fayakun. Ya Allah, we ask you, through your holy names. Al-Asma'ul Husna. And we ask you for the sake of Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In this moment, Ya Allah, Ya Allah, Ya Arhamar Rahimin, لا تدع لنا ذنبا إلا غفرته ولا هما إلا فرجته ولا كربا إلا نفسته ولا ديلا إلا قضيته ولا مريضا إلا شافيته ولا مبتلا إلا عافيته. اللهم ولا حاجة من حوائج الدنيا والآخرة لك فيها رضا ولنا فيها صلاح إلا قضيتها وأنتنا على قضائها يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات المؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات وغافر الذنوب والخطيئات يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم إنا نسألك الصحة والعافية ودوام الصحة والعافية والبركة في الدين والدنيا والآخرة. اللهم شافي مرضانا يا الله عافي متبانا يا الله. اللهم ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب. ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين واجعلنا للمتقين إماما. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وادخلنا بلطفك الجنة يا قرار يا عزيز يا غفار ويا أرحم الراحمين. إلهنا تقبل دعانا منا واجعل طوافك الخفي في كل أمورنا واجعلنا من الذين سبقت لهم منك الحسنى وإلى حضرة الحبيب الأعظم سيد المصطفى محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم أهل بيته وأصحابه وأزواجه وذريته وقرابته والتابعين تابعين بإحسان الدين والعلماء والمحققين والمحدثين والمفسرين وكل من خدم لك بإخلاص هادي وأصحاب المدار الأربعة وروح الأولياء والأتقياء الأصفياء في مشارق الأرض ومغاربها حيثما حلوا وحلت أطوار واحهم الطاهرة. ولا سيدنا الشيخ عبد القادر الجيلاني ولا سيدنا الإمام الحبيب نوح الحبشي وإلى جميع الأتقياء في مشارق الأرض ومغاربها الحبيب محمد والحبيب محمد بن سالم العطاس والحبيب والشيخ عمر الخطيب وجميع الأولياء في هذه البلاد وفي سائر البلدان وعلى هذه النية وإلى حضرة النبي سيدنا محمد. فاتحة.
قبل الله منا